Today, a fellow YouTuber friend of mine made a big mistake. Let's get undone.
Gerald Undone. He's crazy.
What's up, Donk Squad? I'm Gerald Undone, and today a fellow YouTuber asked if I could make them an intro for their YouTube channel. Now, I don't know if they know what they're getting themselves into here. I'm hoping, and I'm assuming that they've seen my intro, and maybe they're thinking I'll make something like that, but I think they've opened up a whole basket here that they may not be prepared for. And I figured this would be a welcome distraction away from the trending test. We'll just take a little bit of a break from the trending test and do something a little bit silly, just kind of relax a little bit. So I'll give you an idea of how the conversation went so you can see kind of where I'm at. And I haven't even seen much of this guy's channel yet, so we're gonna have to look at that too and see if we can figure out how to do the intro. But it went something like this. I said, I've got the conversation up here. I said, what did you have in mind? And he said, the user, by the way, is named Tonic Classic. Tonic Classic said, potatoes. So I, of course, said, can you give me a better idea of your vision? And I also warned him that my intros are a little bit cheesy. And he said, just some music and my name, Tonic Classic, and that's it. And so I let him know, I said, yeah, you know, I can grab my piano or guitar and I can yell some crazy lyrics at a microphone and, you know, animate it poorly. And he said, just say my name for some seconds and add some music. So we've got pretty open field of what we can do here. But anyway, let's go check out his channel and see what we're dealing with so we have a better idea of what exactly, you know, we should make to capture the mood of this guy's channel. All right, so here we go. We are on Tonic Classic and he's got himself a channel trailer. Let's check that out. What do we got here? So we got videos. Let's check them out. So ATV on snow, ATV on mud, free ride and crash. So it seems that the channel is kind of about, what do you call this? Extreme sports, I guess, some of that. Okay. He's got 12 videos. His channel art says Tonic Classic. And we got a guy on a bike. Let's see if we can't get those art assets from him. Maybe he's got that font that he used and that logo. Maybe he's got that. Let's see if we can get that off of him. All right, so I just went and asked him if he can send me over the logos and the fonts and that kind of stuff so we can play with that a little bit. But let's browse around the channel a little bit more, see if we can get an idea of what we're working with here. So, you know, playlists, we got bike. What do we got in the about section here? Nothing really. So after chatting with Tonic Classic a little bit, I asked him if he had any of those photos to send me, and he's using mostly stock photography, so none of those photos are his, and he doesn't have any logos or anything established yet. So we don't really have anything to work with. We're gonna have to start from scratch. But he did say, to make it in your style, make it undone. So I'm not even sure I know what that means anymore. I guess it just means whatever the hell comes to my head. That's what we're gonna do. So I think maybe first, the first thing that we need is a song. Something, you know, with a little, jingle. We gotta get one of those cooking. All right. So let's do some experimental music. So let's get the guitar. All right. What are we gonna do here? So we're talking about mountain biking. Mountain biking, and we can just say his name, Tonic Classic. It'd be funny if I was pronouncing it wrong all the time and his name is like Tonic Classic. Anyway, all right, Tonic Classic. Just say my name, he said. Just say my name. Just say my name. When it comes to making intros, I think that shorter is better. I think you just come up with a really simple, tiny little jingle that always leaves the audience wanting a little bit more and leaves them feeling a little bit like, what was that weird thing I just heard? So I've got a little something here. Maybe we'll work with this. Like, no. Yeah. So a little cleaner like this. Now, if we're gonna use that, because I think that's got a little jingle quality to it, right? Like, now we need to like, so if we're gonna go with that, can we put some words to it, you know? Let's see what he actually said in the chat. Maybe we can use his, maybe he can use his actual instructions for writing the song. He said, my name is Tonic Classic, and that's it. Just say my name. So can we work that in at all? My name is Tonic Classic, and that's it. That's bad. That's funny though. My name is Tonic. My name is Tonic Classic. My name is Tonic Classic, and that's it. My name is Tonic. My name is Tonic Classic. My name is Tonic Classic, and that's it. You think that's anything? I don't know. It's kind of funny, right? So if we go with that, we should record that, and then just do something with wacky text. Because we don't have a picture, we don't have anything to go by. So try to do one clean recording on it so we can play with that. Bring this down a little bit. Okay. My name is Tonic Classic, and that's it. Now to the Photoshop mobile. So for the next step, I'm going to open up Photoshop, and I'm going to try to recreate the font choices that he made for his channel art on YouTube so that maybe we can use that and animate that in some way because we don't really have much. So I'm gonna do a bunch of stuff in Photoshop now and I'm gonna record that and then I'll probably time lapse it out and do a voiceover. So that's probably what you'll hear next. Let's do it. Okay, so I brought the original channel art into Photoshop here so I could take a look at the fonts and see if I could duplicate them. I started off with the classic font and I was able to find it very quickly. It was Century Gothic, made a pretty close match. And I started working on Tonic. And I couldn't find anything to match Tonic, so I took just the T out because that had a pretty identifiable shape and just thickened it and drew it in a little bit better so that when I loaded it up into Font Squirrel, it'd find a better match. And it did. It was a font called Malaysian. It wasn't a perfect match, but it was pretty close. And then I just started working with the classic font that I use. I changed the color to purple and imposed it over top of the original classic font to make it a little bit easier to make some micro adjustments to try to make it fit as best as possible. Then I switched back to the original color and tried to get the stroke to be the same as it was on the original font. I did the same thing with Tonic. Here we're scaling the fonts up in order to get a better quality out of it than the original, and then we're just setting some markers to line it up. Tonic eventually got back to me and sent me this picture of a four-wheeler, which he thought I could use in making the intro, so I took it, but I also wanted to grab a little sunset scene that we'll see here in order to try to make the image look a little bit closer to the original channel art. So I just superimposed the sunset scene, lined up the horizons, and then masked out a little bit of the original color to try to blend them in better. We just changed the blending mode in order to make it look more like the original channel art and added blue to the shadows to capture the original color palette. Then I just added a little bit of a blur effect in order to make it sit better in the background. Then we find the center point of the image so we can put a little bit of a vignette on it. And then I brought in the original fonts and added a drop shadow in order to make them pop a little bit. Now here we're working on the fonts for the other lyrics that we're going to use in the song, the My Name is Tonic section, choosing how to place the fonts and how we want them to appear. And then we separate the different elements and save them separately so that we can animate them in Premiere Pro. We do the same thing for the And That's It lyric and just try to line that up under Classic well so it'll show up in the same spot so we can make the positions change. And then we save out that element separately as well. Now I needed to bring in the footage of this video recording so that I could separate the audio track from the jingle.
My name is Tonic Classic and that's it.
Let me just cut that piece out and move it to a separate piece on the timeline so that we can start to animate the other objects. I made a little bit of a blue background here in Photoshop so that I could use it as a transition card that kind of fits the shadow density. And then we started putting the pieces together, syncing up the lyrics My Name Is to the way that the guitar strums hit at the same time. Did the same thing for Tonic, the same thing for Classic, and the same thing for And That's It. Once I was happy with the way the lyrics were coming in with position-based keyframes as well as cropping, I started moving on to some video transitions using inversion, some cross-dissolve, some wipes, and opacity adjustments. And then we just finished off with a zoom of the final logo zooming into the center of the frame. This part is rather tedious because a lot of it just involves listening to the track over and over and over again and trying to find ways to sync it up perfectly. All right, well, I think that's about done. So there you go, Tonic Classic. Hope you like it. Let's watch it one time, full screen, full audio, and see what we've got by the time then this video's over. I'm going to hate listening to that so much, and you guys have probably already heard like parts of the jingle like 10,000 times. But let's give it one more try. Here we go, from the top.
My name is Tonic Classic, and that's it.
Well, that's something. It's definitely not nothing. That's how you make a YouTube intro with your own recorded music and cheesy Premiere Pro animations. All right. I'm done.